What's going on, Michigan football fans? It's your man, James Yoder, the undisputed king of Michigan football media. Instagram Q&A on the 2019 Michigan offense. Let's get it rolling. Take it away, Caden Helper. You ever need anything done? This guy is going to help you. Hepler, help now. Dyslexia there. Damn it, I was going to try to make a joke. Great last name, Helper, nevertheless. I think he's trying to say, he says, it's the internet, people make typos. Should Michigan fans believe the hype in the new offense with Josh Gattis in control? Look, I'm going to tell you this. If you guys want to get excited about Michigan football in 2019, don't watch anything about Michigan football. Go watch Alabama, Alabama highlights last year, mostly their passing and mostly their wide receiver, because their offense was unbelievable last year. And I think the hype is real. I think Shea Patterson's stats, he's going to have these stats by the eighth game of the year, be it the Notre Dame game or whatever the eighth game is, October, he'll have those 2,600 yards, those 22 touchdowns. I think Josh Gattis can throw the ball 35, 40 times a game on average, where last year Michigan was throwing 20, 22, 25 times, whatever it was. This is going to be an aggressive offense. You go back when he was the wide receivers coach at Penn State. Think about 2017 Penn State, how that offense just waxed Michigan, made them look embarrassing. So my word to Michigan football fans is trust but verify, but this hype is real. I cannot wait to see Jim Harbaugh hands completely off. Gattis, aggressive, wants to be head coach, and the best way to do that is to have one of the best offenses in college football turn around Michigan football. All right, go ahead and subscribe. Michigan Football Report on YouTube. We've got our own channel. Because we're number one, we've just mowed down the competition. It's because of you guys, the smartest, best looking, most American audience of any Michigan football show out there. Make sure you're subscribed, youtube.com/MichiganTV. Next question from Shay Ingles 3. Great follow on Instagram. Hit him back if you are on the IG for some great, sometimes Michigan related content. Will we see Giles Jackson or Cornelius Johnson this year in the lineup? Or is it just Mike Sainristal? Before we show you the depth chart post Oliver Martin, shout out me for breaking that story. Webster is still claiming that. Damn, I said I wasn't going to say his name. Okay. Shane goes, will we see him? Yes, but not as much as you probably would a normal backup. But Michigan's going to run a lot of four wide receiver sets this year, but they have got to play him. Why? Because there are a lot of folks, myself included, who think at least two, if not three Michigan wide receivers are going to leave early to the NFL after this year. Even kind of stupidly, if they're not going to be first-round draft picks. I don't think Tariq Black's going to be a first-round draft pick no matter what he does this year because he's been so injured. And if you're a third-round pick, you come back for your senior year, you bump up to the first round. I mean, you're talking about generational money difference in money. So I'm not sure why they would, but a lot of people are saying that Collins, Peoples-Jones, Tariq Black could go pro. But you see, Cornelius Johnson, he's a big body. There's a big receiver. He's an outside guy. He's going to be backing up Tariq Black, Nico Collins, Mike Sainristal. I've got him as a starter now in that slot position, which isn't, I guess, in the normal three wide receiver set. But when they go four wide, Sainristal's going to be a slot. Giles Jackson, Cornelius Johnson, a lot of reps this year. Nowhere near where DPJ is going to be. But you're going to see those guys on the field from game one. I would expect all three of them, of those freshman wide receivers coming in this year for the University of Michigan. All right. Well, I want to ask you guys a question because the advertisers are getting on me. They're like, James, is something wrong with your numbers, them things? Like, your analytics say all you have is dudes watching your freaking show. So I'm like, I thought I got to bring some sex appeal wearing the Vincent Gray outfit in honor of Michigan's backup quarterback. I thought some girls would look just because they like watching me. Turns out that's not the case. I need to know, I need to verify this. Are you a guy or gal? Just type below, dude, chick, guy, gal, man, woman, boy, girl, whatever you want. But let me know if there's any girls out there, go overboard. Type it a few times because the advertiser's like, we got to have at least some girls watching you, James. If not, kind of a weird setup, but a little sausage party going over there at the Michigan Football Report. Next question, Instagram Q&A, Novak_C30. When his career is over, I think Charbonnet has the potential to be our career rushing leader. WDYT, what's that mean in the streets? What do you think? I might have had to Google that one, you never know. But I like the enthusiasm, Novak. I think you're on to something that Zach Charbonnet has the potential to be special, not a surprise to anyone who's seen his film, seen the kind of, the depth chart he's coming into, which is very sparse. But, we're talking about a pretty stacked leaderboard of guys who were big-time, legendary players, And if we skip Denard Robinson there as number two, because almost all of that done was done at quarterback, although he did have a couple games that he started running back, surprisingly, people forget about that, in 2012. Mike Carr, Anthony Thomas, four-year starters on national championship-level teams for at least a couple of years of their career. Anthony Thomas, the starting running back, the leading rusher on the 97 national championship team, was a second-round draft pick, left the school as leading rusher. Matter of fact, Jamie Morris was the guy, then A-Train beat him, then Mike Hart beat him, and then Tyrone and Denard have kind of put their stamp, although neither one of those guys were never number one. But with it being required for a guy to be a four-year starter, and Michigan's offense is hopefully, we'll believe in the hype, going to a much more pass-heavy shotgun set, I don't think there's any reasonable explanations that Zach Charbonnet should, you know, rival that 5,000 mark of Mike Carr. That's 1,250 yards a year. So you say maybe you break out and have a 1,600 yard year, one of those years or something like that, if you have an amazing season. And that means you still got to almost have 1,000, you know, more than 1,000 actually, the other one. So it's a pretty tough, tall task to do. So I'm going to say no, but he could be the full-time starter here this season and for the next two or three years end up with, 3,500 yards, 4,000. Get on that top five, top 10 list for Michigan. All right, next question. DJ underscore, was that 13, X and three I's? I'm part Roman. You might not even know that. I was training for the Olympics one time too. I know my Roman numerals. How is the offense? He must be from Great Britain, smelling offense with a C. Just kidding there, DJ. How is the offense really going to change, or is Michigan just going to hype up the team more? I think there's a little typo there. Nevertheless, we get the gist. Is the offense really going to change, or is it more of the same bullshit we've heard from the media, from, the guys who waste all their freaking time going to press conferences and just hearing the same over and over talk from the coaches? And last year was the best year ever of all time. It was, how's the playbook looking? We opened it up and Michigan players were telling the media, oh no, we've got something special for Ohio State. Come on, I mean, Michigan has never, every year of my life, I've been following Michigan football for almost 30 years now, closely. Every single year, we're saving the good stuff for Ohio State, for Notre Dame, for Michigan State. Well, I've never actually seen that happen. The only time I've ever been surprised was that 2007 season against Florida when they opened it up. But I am excited for it. I think Josh Gattis signals a new era in Michigan football. And I looked at Alabama's team last year. Look at these receiving stats last year for Alabama. You've got five players, over 40 catches. That is unbelievable. 68 by Jerry Jeudy, best receiver in the country, coming back for his junior year. Henry Ruggs, sophomore last year, coming back for his junior year. Jalen Wild, Irv Smith, NFL-level tight end, he's moving on. Devonta Smith, these are unbelievable stats, folks. And Josh Gattis was in charge of the passing game, and he made a lot of the play design. So I expect, Michigan's wide receiving core is on par with Alabama's was last year. If DPJ, if Treat Black, Nico Collins all stay healthy and Mike Sanders still lives up to what we think he has. So I think it's all good. I am excited for it. Then we can finally buy the hype, but we've still got 2 months almost to the day until we get to see this offense in action. August 31st, 31st, night game, Middle Tennessee State. Keep it rolling. B. Dalton, 1, 2, 4, 124 is a Zach Gentry type tight end on the current roster. Or was the one incoming? Well, people need to get off the Sean McCune train, okay? Sean McCune might get some love because he's a glue guy, he's a locker room guy, but he's not of the talent of a Gentry, of a Zach. But the guy I'm excited about is Nick Eubanks, right? Nick Eubanks is the guy I think will lead Michigan wide receivers in catching, and Michigan tight ends in catches and yards this year. And then behind him, Jake Butts, I can't remember what I said, but yeah, that too, Jake Butt. But Nick Eubanks, I think the local media is going to tell you Sean McCune is the starter. I think Nick Eubanks will be the guy to surprise people. He was big-time player to start 2017, been injured, but I think he's going to be back and better than ever coming up. Sean McCune, Mustafa Muhammad coming into his second year on campus. I think he's the one that will take the reins from Eubanks going on the next 3 or 4 years for Michigan football. And you see these questions, folks. You see they're all coming from Instagram. I have put my best scoops on uniforms, on Michigan's special, special weapon with the running back position. Go ahead and follow me. Need to get to 1,500. If I do, I can do something special for you, the amazing Michigan football audience. So you're nothing to lose here. All I'm giving you is good scoops. I'm going to let you know when recruits are coming in on Instagram. I found the story is the best place to give you the inside Michigan football rumors that you need to know about. All right, keep it moving. Aaron Snow Inc. Same guy from the last show. Aaron Snowy Inc. 12. Appreciate it. Do you think Christian McCaffrey, they don't let us edit these things, Instagram does. I think, you know, he's more familiar with the Stanford brother, the Carolina Panthers. He means Dylan McCaffrey. Will turn out to be a better QB than Shea Patterson. I think he's got a pretty good chance, and for a couple reasons. One, his athleticism is out of this world. I did not expect it, but there was actually one college coach I talked to, a high-level college football head coach, a few years back when Dylan McCaffrey was in high school, who said, hey, we were recruiting him as a tight end or a wide receiver because this kid is fast as heck. And I know his dad, he was a wide receiver. His brother is a high-level NFL running back, lightning fast. Little known, maybe we've talked about it in the past. His grandfather, his mother's father, once held the world record for the mile, I believe, 4-minute mile back like 60 years ago. So he's got all kinds of athleticism. If he can make the throws we saw last year, if he cannot make mistakes, I think Michigan's quarterback production is just going to go up. Shea Patterson's going to have a great year this year. McCaffrey in 20 and 21. And then maybe J.J. McCartney, from 22 and beyond. So I think there's a good chance he could be, but I'm excited about both of their careers. These next 3 years for Michigan is going to be some high-level quarterback play because of this man, H.T. Jones. Not because of H.T. Jones, but he asked the question, H.T. Jones 111, how will Josh Gaddis' offense help Michigan? I've got three ways that it's going to help Michigan in 2019 and beyond. Number one, I think the best players are going to play. And I don't think that's always been the case for Michigan football since I've been watching over 5-6 coaches that have been in my lifetime. I don't think that's always the way things have gone. So I think if Shea Patterson is not performing, Dylan McCaffrey's the best guy, the best player will play, number one. Number two, they're going to take advantage of the entire field, right? And number three, they're going to out-scheme people. For our entire lives, Michigan has played offense, maybe outside of a couple years of the Rich Rod, where they didn't have the talent, but they tried to be aggressive, where Michigan said, oh, we don't really care if the defense knows what play we're running. Go ahead and stop it, because we've got better players. Just, you've got to stop it. Now I think if you pair great talent with a great game plan and great play calls that catch people off guards, that's when you can have an Oklahoma, an Alabama, an Ohio State defense. Let's take a look at last year. A big come up. 2017 was one of the worst years of offense of our lives. Maybe the 08 defense with Rich, or offense with Rich Rod was worse. Michigan still with Shea Patterson, still with these awesome wide receivers, with all conference level offensive line, with Caron Higdon, right? Still, we're number 49 in yards last year, number 79 in passing, number 30 in rushing, number 21 scoring. The scoring is fine, but give a lot of shout outs to the defense on that and getting turnovers and putting them in great field position. Now let's take a look at Alabama, folks. Are you freaking kidding me? Number 6 in the country in yards. And oh, by the way, their quarterback didn't play in the fourth quarter for almost the entire year and at the second half for most of the year. So if Tua had stayed in the game, folks, if those starters had played into the third quarter, fourth quarter, they'd probably be like 650. They'd be number one in all these categories. The only thing that held back Alabama last year was Alabama just not wanting people on Twitter to say, Nick Saban's being a jerk and running up the score, blah, blah. But Josh Gaddis is a big part of that, big part of that passing game. He's going to help with Michigan. He's bringing a kill mindset. And I was told, I put this on my Instagram account a few weeks ago, I think I talked about it on the show, is he asked Jim Harbaugh, it's like, hey, am I going to have to protect the defense? So we're going to do this. And Harbaugh's like, do what you want. And Josh Gaddis has basically said, I want to score as many points as we can. Foot, pedal to the metal, foot on the throat. And Harbaugh's like, it's your offense, baby. So that's exciting. Getting excited about it. Next question up, Michigan football offense, Instagram Q&A in the Michigan Football Report mailbag. Any update on the health and playing status of running back Zach Charbonnet, the second most, the recruit I'm the second most excited about coming into this class behind Daxon Hill. Charbonnet, top 50-60 player in the country. I think all in, he's probably the best running back in the country, although they're quite a few guys ranked ahead of him, enrolled early, and it's a bummer because he got injured, couldn't participate, had a surgery, but had been told you might not see as much from him in the first couple games of the year. They don't want to have him re-injure himself, like a Kevin Durant move or anything like that, but by mid-year, I fully expected him to be getting 15 carries a game, the bulk of the carries from the Michigan offense, out of the state of California, early enrollee. This is one of the best recruitment gets in Jim Harbaugh's career. It's not Rashawn Gary. It's not, it's not J.J. McCarthy. He's not a five-star like that. But the need at running back, mixed with his style of play, mixed with Josh Gattis' offense, is going to be magic for the next few years, I think, as long as Charbonnet gets healthy. Which leads me to this question for you guys, the wonderful Michigan Football Report audience, just some of the finest people in this great country are watching the show, so thank you. Give me an over-under on Zach Charbonnet. 700 yards rushing this year in 2019 as a true freshman. Doesn't seem like a lot, but you look back, very few Michigan freshmen have ever hit that number. Over-over. I'm getting shaken off by the production staff. Like, James, you're an idiot. Quit messing up the things. Over-over, you for under, below, on Facebook Live and on YouTube. Want to know from you guys, Zach Charbonnet, what's he going to do, over 700 or under 700? I am James Yoder, the face of Michigan football media, here on YouTube. Go ahead and subscribe and go blue.